Thanksgiving, the day we gather with friends and family to enjoy turkey, stuffing, mashed potatoes, and pumpkin pie. We throw on the game, catch up on our lives, and then discuss, or quite possibly argue, about religion and politics. For millions of Americans, it's a day of cherished traditions. And as Americans, we certainly value those traditions. But it's also important to unpack the myth of Thanksgiving. It is a holiday riddled with historical inaccuracies, built on this myth that the indigenous welcomed their colonizers with open arms and ears of corn, a simplistic fairy tale interpretation of a 1621 encounter between indigenous tribes and English settlers that erases the genocide that followed. It's the truth Republicans want banned from our textbooks, because here's the secret they want so desperately to keep. We are a country founded on violence. Our birth was violent. In 1619, a ship with more than 20 enslaved Africans landed in Virginia, ushering in two centuries of American slavery that left millions in chains or dead. And when those humans in bondage were finally free, a terrorist organization that was a card-carrying member of polite society, the Ku Klux Klan, picked up where the Civil War ended, using violence to maintain white supremacy. The Klan and its ilk are still active. And as Americans, we continue to choose violence. We are a country that chooses violence over and over again. There is no facet of American society that is untouched by it, as all the recent headlines remind us.
Another thing that they teach in the history book was the whole Thanksgiving, the meeting. But, you know, we talked about that, and I wanted people to know the truth about that. It was actually, if you want to talk about how Thanksgiving came about.
I do want to talk about it. First of all, you got to remember, my dear brother, that history, his story, it's not our story. When they proclaimed Thanksgiving, it was in Mystic, Connecticut. A tribe of Indian people, the Pequots, that were thriving and surviving. But shortly after, we taught these white people how to farm and how to take care of the land and raise food. They got beside themselves. Few years after they started prospering, they decided that they were going to take their women and their children out to a big field and have a cookout celebration. No Indians brought deer. There was never a Thanksgiving dinner with them, according to what they say. Not true. The celebration of Thanksgiving was the men walked off from their families and went further north into Mystic, Connecticut, and he murdered these Pequot Indian children, elders, women, and men. Got them in the enclosure of their habitat. They'd built forts, per se, but that was only for the protection of their people. And they trapped them in where they couldn't get out, and they set it on fire, and they burned them to death. Then they came back. They were so thankful that they had killed these Indians, but that was the first Thanksgiving, not what you read about in their books.
It wasn't until when President Lincoln decided, instead of having it every other day when they were going to different tribes killing them, that he decided to make it once a year, a day of Thanksgiving once a year.
True. But let me tell you about President Lincoln. Because Indians, the Lakota, Dakota, and Nakota Indians, wouldn't give up. These are the people from Minnesota, North Dakota, South Dakota, up in that area, would not give up. They were fighting, and they captured in excess of 200 of them. And they wanted to hang them all. But Lincoln intervened because of politics, should I say politics. And he said, no, I don't want you to hang them all. Pick 38 of them. And that's how they came up with the Mankato 38. That was the largest mass hanging ever in this country, this republic.
And I'm thankful for my kindergarten class who made these wonderful crafts to celebrate Thanksgiving.
After the Native Americans helped the Pilgrims survive their first winter in America, the Puritans invited them to share the first Thanksgiving.
Aww. Oh, these are adorably wrong.
A five-year-old made that.
Based off of the lies that you taught them.
Excuse me?
Oh, it's not your fault. These are full of half-truths and historical propaganda.
I thought the Native Americans and the Pilgrims were like besties or whatever.
At best, the Pilgrims and Wampanoags could be described as political allies. By the time the Pilgrims showed up, not only were two-thirds of the Massachusetts tribes completely wiped out by European slave owners and diseases, the Pilgrims were constantly at war with the indigenous people and routinely tortured them.
But what about Squanto, the Native American who learned English to help out the Pilgrims?
He was actually a slave that was hauled off to Europe, and then he learned English so that he could escape.
But they did celebrate it every year, right?
Not exactly. The next one was 16 years later, and unfortunately, it was because the Puritans were celebrating the massacre of the Pequot tribe. Back then, Thanksgiving was also for families, specifically murdering them.
Okay, we get it. History's awful. The Puritans were terrible. And now we have to let our children know that the holiday started with tons of killings. Happy?
Well, we actually have just about everything wrong with the Thanksgiving myth. Definitely didn't wear these buckle hats. Didn't land on Plymouth Rock. And as for that turkey...
No, not turkey.
More like venison, fowl, and eel.
Oh! Who cares about how this stupid holiday got started anyway?
Exactly. In George Washington's 1789 Thanksgiving Proclamation, the settlers aren't mentioned not even once. Thanksgiving wasn't celebrated nationwide until 1863 when this guy declared it a national holiday during the Civil War in order to bring the country together. That's why all of our foods are from the 19th century.
So Lincoln came up with the whole Indian pilgrim story.
Nope. That myth didn't catch on until the 1900s after we had fought and killed all the Native Americans. And then we put it into textbooks as fact. Because America. But the food is really good, and if you ignore all the terrible history, like, you know, the murdering, the raping, the pillaging, it's still kind of a great holiday. Mm.
So the Mayflower is a lie.
Why do we eat cranberry sauce?
What about stuffing?
Is Black Friday really just a capitalist conspiracy to get poor people to buy things so we can't truly live out a populist revolt?
Or is it
really in America?
Is this really in America? And what about corn?
I am never telling you the truth ever again. One historical narrative says that the Pilgrims were off firing their guns when the Wampanoag tribe just showed up, presumably to find out why the white folks were shooting up the place, which is a question that we still ask this very day.